Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired exegetology preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I render exposition of Luke 2.19 onward. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherd returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told unto them. And when 8 days were accomplished for the circumcising of the child, his name was called Jesus, which was so named of the angel before he was conceived in the womb. So Christ, Jesus, the name Jesus was known to Mary before she had him. And when the days of her purification according to the law of Moses were accomplished, they brought him to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord Yahweh. Because it's the circumcision, all these moral laws are according to the Lord Yahweh, because God is spirit and is free of the moral laws. As it is written in the laws of the Lord Yahweh, every male that openeth the womb shall be called holy to the Lord Yahweh. So this circumcision and all that thing is done in the name of Lord Yahweh, which we call Brahma in our Punjabi or Indian language, and to offer a sacrifice according to that which is said in the law of the Lord Yahweh, a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. And behold, there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon, and the same man was just and devout. So this Simeon, he was just and devout. He was not greedy, he was sealed to serve God. So he attained the light to perceive Christ. People who are cheat, who are fleecing others, they are giving only lip service. And to believe in Christ Jesus, you just need a clean heart. Waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him, because without Holy Spirit you cannot perceive God or Christ. So, and it was revealed unto him by the Holy Spirit. Holy Ghost is different. Holy Ghost is wisdom of men. Holy Spirit is the wisdom of extraordinary wisdom of God, which he possessed, that he should not see death before he had seen the Lord's Christ. Now, Lord Christ is just added on. It was before he has seen the anointed elder brother Christ. And he came by the Spirit into the temple. So it says that Spirit is with capital S, as it is Holy Spirit, the very Spirit of God. So he perceived all the what's happening in the world. So by Spirit he came into the temple, and not by just chance. And when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him after the custom of the law, that means Jesus fulfilled the law. And that's what Jesus said, you know, I danced with them. When I asked them to dance with me, they turned their faces away. Then took he him up in his arms and blessed God and said, God, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, according to thy word. For mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people. That means this is the age, dark age, in which the Christ appears. And Christ is in the beginning and is forever. So there have been through ages a light to lighten the Gentiles. Now a light to lighten the Gentiles means the Gentiles are more clean-hearted people. So they received the light of Christ more than these Jewish people, the chosen people, who were arrogant with the letter, and they were not clean-hearted, they were cheat. And the glory of thy people Israel. So people of Israel form Gentile and Jews. And Joseph and his medium, Mary. Mary was not the mother of Christ Jesus, she was a woman, marveled at those things which were spoken of him. And Simeon blessed them and said unto Mary, his woman, behold, this child is set for the fall and rising against of many in Israel, and for a sign which shall be spoken against, yea, a sword shall pierce through thy own soul also. Now, that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed. So this is a sword which goes through the heart, so that you open your heart, and if any secret you have to expose. So secrets are kept by the hypocrites. So Christ Jesus had the double-edged sword of his word, which he used to open the secrets of the hypocrites. So that soul pierced the hearts and reveals their secrets. So as I reveal their hypocrisy in the Church of England by telling them, if Queen is your head of the Church, who is the head of the Mammon in Great Britain, then how can she defend your faith in God? Hardly any sensible person appreciates this one, because gospel truth is not for everybody unless you are blessed with it, unless you are brave, open-hearted, and you are clean, you are not biased, your heart is like a little child, unbiased, you speak what is in your heart. So that's the sword Christ Jesus bring into our world. And there was one Anna, a prophetess. So there was a lady who was a prophetess, she was devoted to God too, the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher. She was of a great age and had lived with an husband 7 years from her virginity. So she was married only 7 years when her husband died. So she devoted the whole life to God. And she was a widow of about 84 years, which departed not from the temple, but served God with fastings and prayers night and day. So she was highly devoted to God. And she, coming in that instant, gave thanks likewise unto the Lord God, Lord, which is a Yahweh, and she was prophetess with the Holy Spirit too. So she also thanked our Father God, and spake of him to all them that looked for redemption in Jerusalem. Yeah, thank you very much.